up. And this is the first of the supported rides I've done with the Buelk. And was part of the agreement when I did the ambassador programs is that we would do three of these a year where there are 100 or more cyclists. So this is my first. I have another one end of August in Geismar County, 2 weeks. And then one in the middle of September, which is it's called the Grand Fondo Baie-Saint-Marie. So this is the first one. It's probably going to be about 200, 250 cyclists there, I'm going to guess. It's one of the better attended ones in this area. Anyway, I'm going to film it because of the, I've never been in a crowd before with the Buelk. So we'll, plus the fact it's a beautiful area. So I've got the Garmin Verb with me as well. And I'm going to put that on and run it for the run with, on a minimal G-metrics on it. Telemetric stuff, so we can just get a good view of what it's like to ride in the Annapolis Valley of Nova Scotia, which is a beautiful part of the country. So we're here and I'm all registered, and it's a beautiful morning. It's only about 17 degrees out, so it's a little bit cool, which is kind of nice. We're going to start out, it's going to get to a high of about 22. There is a bit of a wind out of the west, so we're going to be pedaling into the wind going into it, which is fine. Because I'm early, now that I'm registered, there's really only three or four people here, but should start filling up soon since registration opens up really in about 2 minutes, and we'll get going. So I'm gonna film it with the Garmin, and we'll have segments of it where it's really nice, you know, because this is a really nice area. So. Thank you.
all turned around.
Thank you.
What's that?
How far did you go?
100.
Oh, nice. I was just making a comment that that's little mobile.
Yeah.
Oh, here's welcome who back. We were looking for. You know this character?
Oh, yeah. My uncle.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah, just making, saying, I wonder if John's back yet or not.
Yeah.
I bet you got lots of looks at this thing.
So far, lots of comments.
Yeah. Okay. Well, anyway.
Which, since I'm a brand ambassador for it, was the intention. That's why it's got all the decals on the side of it, eh?
Right. Yeah. It's neat.
Turned out.
Very nice.
Thank you. Yeah. Okay. Off to get some lunch now, I guess.
Yeah. Good chicken.
Finished off the metric century for Heart of the Valley. It was a good ride, and I'm pretty pleased. It was actually faster than the two training rides that I did, which were flatter. So the first one I did was 3 hours and 38 minutes. Second one was 3 hours and 35. And this one was 3 hours and 33. So getting faster, which is good. It attracted a lot of attention, so I had a lot of discussions with people. It took me, you know, it's now 14:35. I actually finished the ride around 12:30, sorry. And had some lunch and had some talk, showed the bike to people. So doing the brand ambassador thing and exposing it. And, you know, the Heart of the Valley is very well attended. There was probably 200 riders anyway, plus all the staff and everybody else. So it drew a lot. It drew a lot of attention, and that's the intent of what we want to do. So, but I'm tired now. It's 25 degrees, which is not super hot, but still it's a warm ride. Beautiful day. Headwind out for the first 50 kilometers or so, and then I had the wind following me. But a couple of Mondo climbs, which I didn't expect. You know, it's the Annapolis Valley. It's supposed to be flat as a pancake, but not so much. A couple of places outside of there, you know, climbed 100 meters. And so it's still probably only going to be, I would guess, 500 to 1,000 meters of climb all told. Not going to be huge. There's a lot of flat. But it's a good ride. My uncle was on it too. He's a lot fitter than me. He always beats me. He beats me usually by half an hour, 45 minutes. This time we actually finished together. I ran in probably a minute before him. So that feels pretty good because, I mean, he'd be putting out 200, 250 watts. So, you know, keeping up. So some of the really fit cyclists did, but, you know, let's see how it goes. Because the next big one that I have is the Grand Fondo Bay Saint-Marie, and it's got a few good climbs in it, that's for sure. And you know, so I've got a bit of training to do, and that's in mid-September. It's about a month away, and I'll probably take the WA for Guysboro because it has some brutal hills, which I don't think I can get up in the Buelk. But we'll see. If I can train enough, I think it's next weekend, but anyway, if I can train enough, I will probably consider taking the bulk, otherwise I'll take the Contango. But no, all in all, good day, right? Good exposure for the bulk, and I'm pretty pleased with how it all turned out. It was good.
If you like the content of this video, please hit a like or leave me some comments so I know it's important to you and I keep making videos that you want to see. And if you like my channel, then hit subscribe.